from the studios of Adventist World Radio.
Hello and welcome.
This is the International English Service from Pune.
In our program today, we bring music from Pilgrims and Rise,
a true and inspiring story about a famous person.
We shall end our broadcast with a message from God's Word on the topic, Getting Best from Your Bible. This is Maureen.
I'm your host, Sharad, and you're listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope.
Let's begin our program with a song, Living Water by Pilgrims.
You are listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope from Pune, India. And now we have a story about a famous person named John Franklin. This will be presented by Suniti.
Today we are going to talk about a famous person called John Franklin. I wish to charter a ship to the Arctic, Lady Franklin said, coming right to the point. Captain McClintock, you come to me with the highest recommendations. I request you to lead an expedition to find my husband. Thank you, madam, for your confidence, Captain Leopold McClintock replied. What you request will be very hard to accomplish. Already more than a dozen search parties have sought the Arctic for traces of your husband. The authorities believe there is no further hope in finding him, dead or alive. That's the very reason I'm financing this expedition, Lady Franklin said. I can't rest until I know what happened to John. Her voice broke then. Please say that you will go. How can I refuse? Yes, I will go. If the Lord wills, we shall find out what happened to your husband. Thus, Leopold McClintock joined what has been called the greatest manhunt of all times. After several months, he was able to retrace the steps of Sir John Franklin to the place where he and his men had starved to death in 1847 after enduring 2 years of hardships in the Arctic wasteland. Although the search for Sir John Franklin stretched over 12 years and used hundreds of men, it was not the greatest manhunt ever organized. 1900 years ago, God started a bigger manhunt than that. He sent his son Jesus into this world to seek and save boys and girls lost in the icy wilderness of sin. That search is still going on today, and thousands of Christians are helping in the search. They are looking in every continent and island of earth. They are scouring the remotest jungles and searching the wildest desert. So, dear friends, has Jesus found you? Are you his child? Then he expects you to be looking around the school for other boys and girls who are lost. He expects you to be searching your neighborhood for men and women who need him. If you think really hard, I'm sure you can think of something you can do to help in the greatest manhunt this world has ever seen.
Thank you, Suniti, for sharing an inspiring story. We are sure our listeners enjoyed it.
To know more on our program, do write to us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You can also email us on AdventistMediaCenter@gmail.com.
Before you hear God's Word, here's another song, and this is by Rice, entitled Go Light Your World.
Some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Take your candle, go light your world. Frustrated, light his own candle, some other.
Dear radio friend, the Bible is like the ocean. You can wade in it, feed from it, live on it, or drown in it. But those who take the time to learn its truths and practice them will be changed forever. Anyone who bothers to study it finds it to be as limitless as the cosmos. We can go back to the same text countless times and still find more there. No one has ever mastered the scriptures. Time to hear a message entitled, Getting the Best from Your Bible.
Dear listener, the Bible study has largely lost its popularity and centrality in the spiritual life of the believer in the widespread variety of Christian denominations. It is no different within Adventism, once a people of book, yet now a people of... Dear listener, this question remains to be unanswered by a new generation of believers. The profound influence of internet, television entertainment has turned the attention of many from the Bible. Amidst this new cultural phenomenon, the church should not lose hope. In order for faith to be grounded in its true foundation, Bible study must be brought back to its original role. And perhaps one way to restore the significance of Bible study in the mind of the believer is to speak of what Bible study is not. Bible study should not be considered a spiritual burden. It can be pleasant, enjoyable, and incredibly relevant in everyday life. The majority of Christians who do read their Bible on a daily basis do so out of a sense of duty to either God or while preparing a sermon. In many cases, they get nothing out of their Bible reading. Yet, this reality must be changed. Dear listener, let's have a goal, and that is
I would challenge each one of you, dear listener. The goal is not only to motivate members to spend more time in the Word to experience true revival and reformation, but furthermore, to hear God's voice speaking out of the Bible every day. Secondly, dear listener, read for quality, not for quantity. For some reason, most people get into their heads the idea that they must read a large amount of their Bible each day in order to be spiritual. This is simply not true. Spirituality is not based on schedules. Spirituality is based on the quality time spent with Christ through His Word, no matter the time of a day. The best way to read the Bible is to read slowly, prayerfully. Before the Bible is opened, pray that God would speak in a special way. People often rush through the text and miss many opportunities to see details God tried to communicate in the reading. Also, dear listener, keep in the mind that God is not a genie in a lamp. He does not speak at our command. And sometimes it takes time to be able to hear the voice of God through the reading of Scripture. Wait for God's guidance into a journey through His Word, and in time He will speak clearly. It is here that true transformation takes place. Meditate, thirdly, dear listener, meditate on each daily chapter. The Bible tells us to meditate on the Word. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, Psalms chapter 1 verses 2 and 3. This meditation has nothing to do with having the eyes closed or to hum a single note continually. It has to do with pondering, considering, enjoying the Word of God as a baby enjoys her mother's milk. Ask God to bless with a thirst for the Word and to satisfy this daily thirst in a transformative manner through the Word. It is the meditation on the Word of God that brings the Bible alive. Without this meditation, there will be a struggle in seeing the relevance of the Scriptures in daily life. Consider the reading and contemplation of the Scripture would be regarded as an audience with the Infinite One. What a privilege, dear listener, to read the Bible and understand through prayers and meditation. Lastly, dear listener, keep your ears open. The secret to reading the Scripture is to keep the ears open to that which has happened previously in the text read, and to think how this text speaks of God. It is His example that sets the foundation of transformation, and the way He worked in the life of many erring men and women, transforming them into warriors of faith by His grace. Fit yourself in the story. Learn from their mistakes, rejoice in their victories, and be assured that the Bible reading will never lack relevance. Dear listener, you don't have to read a lot of the Word of God for the Bible to become real to you. Each day, God will demonstrate the power and relevancy of His Word to you as you think on and meditate on what He gave you that day in your reading. Dear listener, we pray that you as person, young or old, leader, teacher, doctor, nurse, engineer, listener, will be motivated, will be revived by His Word as well. We challenge you to motivate, encourage your family and friends to become more committed to the Word of God. God bless you as you keep learning God's Word. Let's pray. Our loving and living Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for life and its opportunities that we have to learn more about You through the Bible, Your Word. May it speak to us as we study it daily. We accept You as our personal Savior. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Dear listener, the Bible merits our attention because it is the truth of God, inspired and preserved for us.
Sure, God who made us has given us His book, and we need to make it our book by reading it, poring over it, meditating on it, and putting it into practice. We begin to know God Himself. In the process, we fulfill for ourselves the psalmist's quest. I have sought your precepts. I have seen the consummation of all perfection. Psalms 119 verses 94 and 96. Dear listener, is the Bible at the top of your reading list today?
There's a gentle breeze that's blowing by the river, and it brings a calm assurance to my soul. As I feel your presence come to rest beside me, Spirit, come to cleanse and make me whole. I hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees above, as I stand in awe of nature's wondrous scene. And Lord, I've come to understand the purpose of your master plan, and what all of your creation was to me. By that river, Lord, I hear you speak to me. In the leaves that rustle on the lofty tree, your gentle touch is all it takes to strengthen me. By that river, Lord, is where I wanna be. I remember, Lord, your sacrifice on Calvary, how you proved your love and did it all for me, how you bore the thorns, nails and scorns with dignity, oh, just to save a sinful wretch like me. By that river, Lord, I wanna be forever
singing
praises to the Lamb who set me free. And Lord, I know if I can make it to that river with you, my God, all it takes to strengthen. By that river, Lord, is where I want to be.
With this, we have almost come to the end of our program. Trust you've been blessed. To learn more on God's Word, we would love to receive your letters on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You can also email us on AdventistMediaCenter@gmail.com.
You may also follow our programs on our website, awr.org/English India.
Do join us again along with your family and friends.
Until then, we wish you goodbye and God bless you.